Hello everyone. In today's video, we will show how to classify a Landsat 8 image using a supervised classification method in ArcGIS actually. So here I'm using ArcGIS 10.8. You can use another earlier version, but all of the methodologies are same. So let's go ahead. First of all, we need to just download the image from USGS Earth Explorer, or you can use Landsat Landlook or Glovis platform to download Landsat images. And I've downloaded these images from Glovis actually, and then I also composited all of the bands. So let's see the properties of this image. And here you can see that all of the bands, band 1 to band 11, are composited into a single multispectral images. And you can see here the red, green and blue channel. So I have layer stacked this image, and you can also call this as band composition. Then I have clipped in the images according to my study area. Actually my study area is Tangwar Haur. So you can see here that all of the water bodies, Haur areas, and shallow water bodies here, and also the vegetation coverages which are showing as color red. So first of all, what we need to do classify these images using supervised classification, we just need to check our extension of ArcGIS. So go to customize and see the extensions are enabled here. So you can see here that the all of the extensions I have checked there, and I recommend you to check all of the extensions to work any type of your analysis. So I'm closing this one, and then we need a toolbar called image classification. So we are going here that customize menu, then toolbar option, then you can go there image classification toolbar. Okay, so click on this, and there toolbar appear here. So we will drop it to this toolbar menu. Okay, you can also call this ribbon. So you can see the various band composition of this image. So I have created a false color composition using band 5, band 4 and band 3. Actually these three bands showing the vegetation coverage and water bodies very clearly. So you can do as you wish, or you can use the guideline from Landsat website. USGS has a lot of resources regarding this band composition. So then we will go their image classification. So we will use this interactive supervised classification. So for now you are watching that this option is disabled here. So what will we do? We will just click on this training sample manager, and a dialog box appeared here. So first of all, we need to collect all of the training samples from these images according to our classification or our classes, land classes, land cover classes. So for this one, I will use total 4 to 5 class, and according to these classes, I will collect nearly 8 to 10 sample for each class actually, which will give me better result. So I am selecting this one, This is a draw polygon option or draw polygon tool actually. So I will draw various polygon according to my classes to set my training sample, and then I will save it. So first of all, I am checking the vegetation area. So all of this red area, these red, bright red areas are actually vegetation area, and you are seeing there light red area there. These are actually agricultural land, and you can see, you can also call them as wetland area of actually this is the Haur area of Bangladesh. So I am collecting my what called vegetation samples. So these are bright red, it means these are healthy vegetation actually. So I'm collecting vegetation samples from various areas from this image randomly. So I recommend all of you that you collect the samples from all of the from all of your study area, not from a single part from images. So I'm collecting this vegetation area from this riverside, also from this one. Try to collect bright vegetated areas, which will give you a more accurate result. So I'm collecting these six. Go to the bottom option. So I'm collecting from here. Here seven, and then I'm going here eight. I will collect two more vegetation sample. So I'm selecting this, okay, and also from yeah, I can collect from this area. It's a bright red actually, have very healthy vegetation. Okay, so you see here that I've collected total 10 sample. So I will merge this. So you can merge this one by pressing shift key and click on the last one. All of these samples will be selected, and then you just click on this button, merge training sample. Okay, so here all of the samples are merged into a single class. So I will give it a name as vegetation. So write this as vegetation. Okay, and I will change the color as green. So you can see all of the sample here from randomly collected all over the areas. So now I will collect the water body. So here you can see two types of water bodies. One is actually the shallow water, which is mostly this area. This is actually called Dharmapasha Upazila, and this area are mostly contain the deep water. So this is Tahirpur Upazila of Silet Division actually. So I'm collecting the deep water firstly, and this is the brackish water actually. Brackish means not brackish actually, this is black type of water color. So I'm collecting this as much as I can ensure. Okay, so one, I will collect total five sample from this deep water. Okay, so now, okay, this one, another one is needed. Okay, okay, we have collected all of the deep water actually. So deep water body, I'm merging this five, and rename as deep water. Okay. So I will also change the color as bright or dark ultra blue. Okay, this is actually I think this is okay. And then I'm collecting all others that these are the shallow water bodies. So I will also collect total 5 samples from these areas. And one thing you need to keep in mind that this is a river actually, and this is a stagnant water. So you need to collect from those water body to train your model properly actually. So I'm collecting from various sources or various areas. This is my river area actually. So collect this one, and I will also collect from this area. Okay, and this area can be collected also as well, shallow water. So we are seeing these are my samples of shallow water. So I'm merging this and give it a name as shallow water. Okay, so our 3 sample have done, and we will also collect samples for other areas actually. Other area means this is sand fill areas, or this is agriculture areas. So these are other areas of this my okay tag images. Okay, another from this one. This is actually agricultural land. So you can also identify this as agricultural land. Okay. Total 4 collected, and I will also collect another one from this area. This white cell actually. Actually these are the sand fields area, so people when migrate from one place to another, they build their new houses using the sand fill method or sand filling the areas. Okay, so merge this one, and I'm giving this as other areas. Okay, color. Okay, this is okay for me, color. Okay, so I'm saving this into my project folder, and where is Tangor Tower? So Landsat images. Yeah, this is actually 2019 images, so I will save in my 2019 folder, and I will save as signature. Actually, this is my tutorial signature. Tutorial signature. Okay, so I've saved this one, and now you see here that interactive supervised classification have activated. So what will you see next? When I can click on this button, this will collect the training sample from this one, and this will apply the supervised classification into this image. So I'm clicking on this one. You see here that my vegetated areas. So what will I do? I will change this vegetation color as this one, and also the outline 0. Okay, deep water outline 0, shallow water, this is really okay. Then it is outline 0, this one, and then other areas. So I can give it a color, right? Mango, yeah, mango color is enough for this one. So outline 0. So you can see here that all of the vegetated areas, other areas, and also the shallow water, deep water, other areas have classified from this image. So if you take more time to classify your image, it will be more accurate, and this is actually the method to classify the image or the satellite image using ArcGIS, actually supervised classification. So that's all for today. Thank you everyone. Bye bye.